From weird crocodile-like monsters to bizarre sea creatures that look like something out of a science fiction story, here are the 10 biggest prehistoric animals that are still alive today. Number 10, Gharial. All crocodiles, caimans, and gators are old species, and they look like it. In any case, one type of crocodilian, the gharial, some of the time called a gavial, beats them all in the ancient-looking magnificence challenge. Gharials have long, thin, blade-like mouths loaded with buzzed teeth. The males of the species do something strange, though. They build up an enormous, bulbous nose towards the end of their snout, making them look rather amusing. Gharials or similar species have been around for a really long time, well before the first apes climbed down out of the trees in Africa and became early humans. Yet the cutting-edge gharial of today is the scion of this noble family. Too bad, it is also headed towards extinction, with less than 200 individually identified mating-age gharials left in the wilds of South Asia. It currently lives in India, Bangladesh, and Pakistan. The IUCN has recorded it as an endangered species. Without intervention, it could go extinct in the wild soon enough. Luckily, the Kukrail Reproduction Center at Kukrail Forest Reserve in Lucknow, India, has been assuming a huge part in gharial preservation endeavors by breeding and rearing the animals and sending them out to zoos everywhere in the world. The center is also open to people in general, so you can get very close to these staggering monsters. Small numbers of the gharial species are likewise present at Chitwan National Park and Bardia National Park in Nepal. Number 9, Komodo Dragon. Shocking animals like mastodons, monster ground sloths, saber-toothed felines, and even dire wolves, that's right, they were the real deal and weren't only in Game of Thrones, have tragically become wiped out since the last ice age finished around 11,700 years back. But you can discover these strange-looking animals, which are the closest thing we have to a fantasy dragon, in Indonesia today. They are called the Komodo dragons, or the Komodo monitors, and even though they are limited in habitat today, these notable reptiles had a larger territory initially. Researchers, as of late, uncovered a significant discovery of Komodo winged serpent fossils in eastern Australia, going back about 4 million years prior. Similar animals in the same genus have been around for over 40 million years. They are a close living relative to the legendary dinosaurs of the Cretaceous period. These immense reptiles can weigh more than a human at 10 feet and about 150 pounds, and indeed they have been known to assault people. That isn't ideal since these monster reptiles are venomous and their jaws have a chemical that keeps their victims' blood from clotting. This means if they bite you, you will bleed out. Be that as it may, in case you're feeling courageous, you can see Komodo dragons, the largest existing lizard in the world, by booking with one of a few tourism agencies driving journeys to Komodo National Park. The little Indonesian islands that make up this park are dazzling and offer numerous conveniences for inquisitive vacationers. Number 8, Shoebill Stork. Nobody's very certain of exactly how the shoebill stork is identified with different winged animals. Of course, it has to be a bird, but where does it belong on the family tree? Since various assortments of information highlight diverse living family members, the truth is not clear. However, one thing researchers concede is that this is an ancient flying creature. What's more, it looks like it. Grayish, and with a large, goofy-looking demeanor, it looks like it is something out of a bizarre comedy film or perhaps a surreal painting. Shoebill storks are considered vulnerable species because of environmental annihilation and poaching. They don't know how to defend themselves from predators. In any case, you can observe them in a secured territory of the Mbamba Bay wetland in Uganda, where a few suppliers offer flying creature spotting visits. As you paddle through the shallow lakes and swamps that look the same as the ancient bogs that have been sitting there for millions of years, you might possibly forget where you are and get lost among the shoebill storks. Be careful out there. The wilderness is unforgiving. Number 7, Bactrian Camel. Even without dinosaurs or woolly mammoths, it doesn't mean you're stuck between a rock and a hard place if you're trying to observe ancient creatures today. There are still a lot of natural life species that originate before written history, and they even exist as they did back before cavemen had even thought of writing, the wheel, or the invention of fire. This includes the dromedary camel, the one-humped camel utilized as transport in the Middle East before cars existed. Did you realize that they developed from the two-humped Bactrian camel, a species which still has some members meandering the hills and valleys of the Gobi Desert in Mongolia? Bactrian camels, which have been legendary throughout history as methods of transport before mechanized vehicles, evolved to withstand temperatures underneath 0 degrees Fahrenheit or more than 100 degrees Fahrenheit approximately 2 million years ago. Different camel species existed as far apart as the Sahara Desert and the High Arctic in Canada. It's no surprise since they evolved to be able to survive in all types of climates. Today, only a few subspecies survive, mostly as domesticated beasts of burden in harsh climates. And it makes sense. Their two mounds are utilized to store fat, which the camel separates into energy and water to support it during long, dry, low food periods. If only we could lose fat that effectively as well. Bactrian camels are truly in peril in the wild, as an endangered species with less than 1,000 remaining as per the IUCN. Notwithstanding, trained Bactrian camels make up a significant portion of Mongolian culture, and various tourism agencies offer camel riding tours and other adventures on camelback. Also, guests can look at the yearly Thousand Camels Festival held towards the beginning of March in Umnugovi, Mongolia. Have you ever ridden on a camel? Many people who visit the Middle East, North Africa, or South Asia take the opportunity to ride on one with a tourism agency or at a wildlife center. How was your camel experience? Tell me about it in the comments below. Then be sure to subscribe to The Biggest for more amazing videos just like this one. Number 6. Echidna. Echidnas are stunning and odd animals that resemble a cross between a badger and a porcupine, though they aren't quite like anything else. They're a monotreme, a sort of unique branch of the evolutionary tree in that it's a mammal that lays eggs instead of bringing forth live children. This is just like their renowned family member, the platypus. These creatures can likewise be elusive in the wild, since they're little, generally nocturnal, and live a scattered and single life. There are even ongoing worries about their endangered status, which is particularly sad because they have been around for millions of years. Today, these creatures are in critical danger, with around 50,000 individual members of the species left, as per the IUCN. Not many zoos have these creatures, and it's significantly harder to see them in the wild, even though the Askania Nova Biosphere Preserve in Ukraine has a little group you can see. After 17 or so million years, it looks like human intervention is the only thing to really threaten these bizarrely cute, shy animals. On the off chance that you want to see a live echidna with your own two eyes, your smartest choice is to visit one of the numerous zoos in the South Pacific countries of New Zealand or Australia. Tasmania is known for having echidnas as well, because like most strange, exotic creatures, they make their homes in the far corners of the world. They can be found at the Bow Norong Wildlife Sanctuary in Hobart if you want to get far away from most population centers and find yourself in the great land down under. Funnily enough, the echidna is also represented in the Sonic the Hedgehog video game series, where Sonic's friend and rival Knuckles is the most famous echidna today. Number 5. Musk oxen. Musk oxen can be a serious sight and smell to see, particularly throughout the fall rutting season. During this period, bull musk oxen fight over who will get to mate with the females of the species, with violent results. People may ponder how exactly these animals endure, however, scientists have shown that they've been around for over 130,000 years. This would make them contemporaries with very early hominid species. During the 1800s, they were driven to extinction in Alaska, but they were reintroduced during the 1930s. it's no surprise that they jumped right back into the ecosystem there. Right now, there are a few thousand musk oxen in Alaska. However, their numbers have been dropping as of late. The best spot to see them, if you want to take the time to find musk oxen in the wild, is in Nome, Alaska, where they consistently meander close to the little village. Nome also marks the end of the Iditarod Dog Sled Race, a famous event in rural Alaska. The most famous product of the musk oxen is known as kivyut, which is harvested from the animals and used to make warm clothes. Of course, it has to be warm in order to keep the oxen warm during the Arctic winter. Number 4. Vicuña. In South America, another ancient creature known for its wool is the vicuña, the current alpaca's predecessor. The two creatures look fundamentally the same, as to be sure. However, vicuñas have an unmistakable shading design, white with an earthy colored splash of fur across most of their body. After the Inca Empire fell, this valuable creature almost became extinct. But today, there are a large number still roaming the wild, thanks to the efforts of humans who protected the last few members of the species. It's a remarkable success story, and you can find vicuñas in Peru roaming all over the place. Number 3. Chambered Nautilus. This creature naturally lives around Australia and Indonesia in some of the warmest oceans on the planet. Of course, the Monterey Bay Aquarium in California has its own population of the chambered nautilus, and you can find them sitting around the tanks in captivity for your viewing pleasure. These animals look like strange, swirled cones of ice cream, or curly French fries, but actually are among the most ancient on the planet. They are at least 500 million years old and still look the same as their ancestors did all those years ago. Now that's the sign of a successful species. They're hard to raise under humans' watchful eyes for reasons we still can't explain. However, researchers are trying to figure out the solution. Recently, workers at the Monterey Bay Aquarium did actually convince the Nautilus to reproduce in captivity, which is heartening work considering the way their wild population numbers are heading. Number 2. Tuatara. This old reptile looks as normal as a regular iguana, but it's known by scientists to have existed even before many of our favorite dinosaurs, at least 200 million years. Today, the Tuatara's body contains pieces of information about this old history. They have a strange third eye on the highest point of their head, but it appears to be mostly a vestigial organ on adult members of the species. Also, Tuataras can, oddly enough, hear sounds, even though they have no external ears, like current reptiles. This is like how fish hear sounds while underwater, with the vibrations traveling through their skin. Tuataras can be found in New Zealand, but it's almost impossible to find them naturally in the wild since they live in remote wooded areas on uninhabited stretches of land. But if you're really interested in seeing them, you can go visit them at the zoo in Auckland or Wellington. Number 1. White Rhinoceros. The first thing to know about this animal is that there are two subspecies, the northern white rhinoceros and the southern white rhinoceros. The only surviving northern white rhinos are female, which means the species will go extinct without some very strange genetic juggling from our most advanced scientists. The southern white rhino, however, has a population over 17,000 in the wild around the world. This is a massive conservation success, despite the danger from poachers who collect the horns to sell in traditional medicinal treatments. These majestic animals are millions of years old as well, and are one of the proudest examples today of an ancient megafauna. Almost all the other large animal species of 10 million years ago or more are long gone. If you want to see them in the wild, visit Kruger National Park in South Africa, home to many glorious animals, the most in any one spot in Africa. It has elephants, rhinos, hippos, and more. This is the place to go if you want to take a safari vacation. Which of these prehistoric relics that are still around today did you like the most? Tell me in the comments below. Remember to subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next video. Till then, thanks for watching.